Hello everyone, I welcome you to my channel. Today I'm going to show you how to install PostgreSQL in your industrial operating system. So, let's begin. Now, I have already made a video on how to install PostgreSQL in industrial operating system, but recently PostgreSQL and pgAdmin interface has been changed and many of my students are facing some issues, so I decided to make a video about this update. So for that, you need to first go to your favorite browser and you need to first type PostgreSQL download. And the first one is add. If you just scroll down a bit, you'll be seeing this www.postgresql.org is basically our first search result. So you know, just simply click on this download PostgreSQL. I'll be also putting the link in the description, so you don't need to worry about the link and all. So you'll get the link in the description. And here, this is basically, you know, the official website of PostgreSQL, and their software are available for Linux, macOS, Windows, and Solaris and BSD operating systems. In this video, I'm going to show you how to install PostgreSQL for Windows. So for that, you need to just, you know, simply click on this Windows. This will, you know, automatically going to redirect you to this Windows installer page, and you can clearly see the latest version is version 13. So what I'll be doing is, you know, I'll be, you know, simply clicking on this download the installer link. So you know, just simply click on that. This will, you know, going to redirect you to this page. So in here you can clearly see the version is 13.3. So their version is updated for macOS Windows. So for Windows installation, you need to, you know, just simply click on this download button. This will, you know, going to automatically going to start downloading PostgreSQL. So it's now currently, you know, started downloading. I have already downloaded it, so just, you know, simply cancel it. And if I just simply minimize my browser and if I just go to my download directory, you can clearly see this PostgreSQL 13.3-1 has been, you know, rightly downloaded over here. And the file size is 262 MB. To install PostgreSQL, just, you know, simply double click on it. And then after giving administrator privileges, just, you know, simply minimize my download directory. And you can clearly see our PostgreSQL has been, you know, rightly launched. So this is basically, you know, our PostgreSQL installation wizard. So in here, just, you know, simply click on this next. Now this is going to be, you know, your installation directory. That is the C program files PostgreSQL 13. If you want to change your installation destination, then you need to just simply click on this browse button and you can change that. But in this video, I am going to, you know, keep this all default and then just, you know, simply click on next. So these are the files that, you know, going to be installed at this PostgreSQL server, then pgAdmin 4, then stack builder, then command line tools. So, you know, check all this and then just, you know, simply click on next. And this is going to be, you know, your data directory, that is this PostgreSQL 13/data. So, you know, keep this all default, then just, you know, simply click on next. In here, you need to give a password. So, you know, let's give a password as per your wish. So I am giving my own password. So you need to retype your password. Then, you know, simply click on next. So this is going to be, you know, your port number. That is this 5432. So, you know, this is very important. You need to just remember this port number for, you know, programming and all. I'll be telling you that later. And now just, you know, simply click on next. And now just again click on next. So these are the files that, you know, going to be installed. So they showing this pre-installation summary. So, you know, simply check this and just, you know, simply click on next. And now it's telling that it's ready to install. So for installation, just simply click on next. So this will, you know, going to start in. JS, that is basically, you know, my directory, and then just, you know, simply click on next so that it gets downloaded in this directory. Now the thing is, you need to have an active internet connection right throughout this installation. You can clearly see that it's now currently downloading that package. So it has you know, rightly downloaded. So just, you know, simply click on next for installation of that package. And you can clearly see the setup JDBC pop-up came. So, you know, just click on next. And this is going to be, you know, your installation destination. So just simply keep this all and then just, you know, simply click on next. And it's now ready to install. So next for installation. So this will, you know, going to install this pgJDBC. In my case, I am installing this pgJDBC. In your case, you might install some other, you know, package and all. So you can do that. And now just, you know, simply click on finish. And now it's telling that this installation has been, you know, rightly completed. So just, you know, simply click on finish. So now that you have rightly installed PostgreSQL, it's time to, you know, install a GUI interface. So for that, just again, simply go to your favorite browser and you need to just, you know, simply type pgAdmin download. So pgAdmin is basically, you know, a GUI interface. So you need to again click on this button. I'll be also putting the link in the description. So pgAdmin 4 is basically, you know, gives you a GUI interface. Using that interface, you can code your SQL program. So this is basically, you know, this official website of pgAdmin. So just, you know, simply scroll down a bit and you'll be getting this download button for Windows. So just, you know, simply click on that. This is, you know, going to open this page. So in here you can clearly see that latest release is this in April 22. So just, you know, simply click on this pgAdmin 4, and this will, you know, going to redirect you to this page. So you need to click on this pgAdmin 4-5.2. So just, you know, simply click on that. So this will, you know, going to start downloading this pgAdmin 4. I have already downloaded it, so just, you know, simply cancel it. And if I just minimize my browser and if I just simply go to my download directory, you can clearly see this pgAdmin 4 5.2 version has been, you know, rightly downloaded over here. And the file size is 134 MB. To install, just, you know, simply double click on it. And after giving administrative privileges, just, you know, simply minimize my download directory. And this is basically, you know, our pgAdmin 4 installation wizard. So, you know, just simply click on next and just accept this license agreement. If you have time, you can read this license agreement. And now just, you know, simply click on next. So this is going to be, you know, your installation destination for pgAdmin 4. So if you want to change that, you can just simply click on browse and you can do that. And you need to have 426.5 MB of free disk space in your C directory. So this is very important. You need to check this, that you are at least having this much amount of free disk space. And then just, you know, simply click on next. This is going to be, you know, your they basically, you know, going to create this pgAdmin 4 directory. So, you know, just keep this all default and then just, you know, simply click on next. And it's now currently, you know, ready to install. So for installation, just simply click on install. So this is, you know, going to, you know, automatically start installing pgAdmin 4. It will take a couple of minutes, so I'll be coming back after installing pgAdmin 4. Yeah. So welcome back, and now as you can clearly see, our pgAdmin 4 has been, you know, rightly installed. So you know, just simply click on finish. Now previously what this pgAdmin 4 used to do is they used to just, you know, simply open a browser and they used to, you know, give this interface in browser only. Now they have developed a pgAdmin app exclusively for Windows. So for that, just, you know, simply click on this search icon and just, you know, simply type pgAdmin 4. So this will, you know, going to give you this search result called pgAdmin 4. Just, you know, simply click on that. You'll be seeing a desktop app is now currently opening. Previously, what is to happen is they use this browser. Now they have developed this app. So this app will give you a very good interface, this graphical user interface. Using that, you can, you know, code your SQL program. So now, as you can clearly see, this pgAdmin 4 is now currently launching. It will take some time because, you know, I'm just opening pgAdmin 4 for the first time. So for the first time, it will take some time. And now this pgAdmin 4 has been, you know, directly launched. So let's first, you know, simply maximize it. It will ask for password. So, you know, just give some time. And now, as you can clearly see, that it has, you know, rightly asked your password. So you need to give that password that you have used during installation of PostgreSQL. So give that password. And now just, you know, simply click on OK. And now you are basically inside this pgAdmin 4. So, you know, just simply click on this drop down server. It's telling that whether you'd like to save this password. I would like to, you know, not save this password right now. So this is what you'll be getting after installing PostgreSQL and this pgAdmin 4. So this PostgreSQL is basically a database that days to give after installing PostgreSQL. In here, I'd like to show you how we can create a sample database. So for that, just, you know, simply click this database and then just right click on it and then simply click on create database. So in here, you need to give a database name. So let's give a database name as a new DB. Now it's totally your wish about this database name and all. So, you know, just give a database name, and if you just click on this SQL, you can clearly see that this is basically, you know, the syntax for creating this new DB database. So create database with owner. Owner is basically, you know, PostgreSQL. So this is what is to use in your Java program as a, you know, user ID, and the encoding version is UTF-8 and connection limit is -1. So, you know, keep this all default and just, you know, simply click on save. This will, you know, going to create this new DB database. And now you can clearly see this new DB database has been, you know, rightly created. And so just, you know, simply click on this drop down icon. So this is going, so this is basically, you know, your schemas and all. So in this table, you can clearly see that you have no table right now. So I'll be showing you how to create a new table. So for that, you need to just click on this new DB, then right click on it, and then, you know, just simply click on this create script. So this will, you know, going to open a new, you know, scripting area. So just press enter to, you know, give some writing area. So in here, you can create a new, you know, table. So for that, just, you know, simply type create table. Let's give a table name as employee. Then you know, give the column name first. So let's say person ID is basically, you know, my first column name, and its data type is int. Then full name, let's say, is my second column, so varchar 255. And let's give another column as address, which will be also, you know, going to be varchar 255. So this is basically, you know, our schema for this table employee. So just simply select this and just, you know, simply click on this run button. This will, you know, going to create a new table, and you can clearly see this query returns successful. So if you just first select this schema, then right click on it and just, you know, simply click on refresh, you'll be seeing, just, you know, scroll down a bit, you'll be seeing this employee table has been, you know, rightly created, and our column is person ID, full name and address. You can always, you know, visualize your table by just, you know, simply typing select star from star from employee. Just, you know, simply select this and just, you know, simply again click on this run button, and you can clearly see this table has been, you know, rightly visualized over here. You can always insert some columns. Let's say I want to insert, so for that, you know, just simply type insert into employee, so person ID is basically my first column, then full name, my second column, address. and now just give a value. So let's give the ID as, let's say 001. Then let's give the name as Sourav Ganguly, and let's give the address as Kolkata. So you know, just write this insert statement, then select this and just, you know, simply click on this run button. So this is, you know, going to insert our data, and our query select is, you know, rightly completed. So again, select this, select start from employee, and again click on this run button, and you can clearly see this data has been, you know, rightly inserted. That is, this person ID is 1, the name is Sourav Ganguly, and address is Kolkata. So in this way, you install PostgreSQL and pgAdmin 4. I have rightly shown you this updated version. Then I have also shown you how to create a simple database, and I have also shown you how to create a table and how to insert data in your table. So that's basically all about this video. I have this website called geekyscript.com. In here, you'll be seeing various tutorials along with some blogs that I have written. So do check our website geekyscript.com. So that's all for this video, friends. If you have any queries, do mention in our comment section. So that's all for this video, friends. Thank you very much for watching this video. If you like this video, then please give it a like and also do share with your friends. Thank you very much for watching this video, and God bless you all.